Hey, this is Ben from 20mm, and today we're going to start the journey how to paint the DRK infantry, and it will be a kind of 50 shades of yellow. I'll show you. In my last video, I started to base and to prime all my DRK infantry, which I want to finish soon. And now I have the hard choice on which of these nice yellow colors I have to take. So I prepared like green, brown, sand yellow and desert yellow, which are maybe a short choice. Then the same color as my primer here, the desert yellow, ice yellow, green ochre, lemon yellow, flat yellow, and I have some more options. And if you compare the packagings of the different vendors here, so Revell tells me it can be sand, and then we have different options for the Italieris. It could also be sand or flat dark sand yellow, and the other Italieri box is even aiming for a more green brown tone. And yeah, I'm wondering how to start now, and since I primed with desert yellow, I think I might try the sand yellow, which seems a bit lighter than the base color, and I'm aiming for a shade at the very end, and probably going to take Agrax Earthshake, so a brighter yellow is quite fine for the base coating. And I will try some of the flash colors here, so maybe a sunny skin tone and a dark flash will probably do, since a flat flash for people being in Africa for some time seems too bright. Let's start with the biggest parts of the figure, so paint that so you don't have to take care so much. If you paint wrongly, you will overpaint it while aiming for the next details of the figure. So I didn't use some of my colors for quite some time, and what I do to ensure that it's still properly mixed, I put in these metal balls, which are called agitator balls. But you can easily, I've seen it in other videos, also use small rocks to put in. And then you need to shake for some time so that they look equally colored again and not like these, for example, which might also be broken, or others where all the color is stuck somewhere, or even partial of the colors are here green. So shake it well before using it to get a decent result. Okay, so I start with the main parts, so the uniform of this figure, and since it's a first color and we will apply details later, you don't have to be so careful. Still, you don't want to apply color to all the things you definitely paint in another color. So I mainly try covering the uniform here. My brush had a little water on it. Don't use too much water, or especially the bright colors will not cover. Depending on the result you want to achieve, you maybe even need to put 2x color of it on it. Since I used the darker yellow for prime as prime color, I don't have to care so much, so everything I don't cover properly will shine in the darker yellow tone. And just to see it closer here, the arms are not covered, and I also put some color on the base here. Sand yellow should be nice to extend my yellow base. And now I have to just do it a couple tens times till I have as much as I want. Probably I've just finished this 6, 7, 8 and try out the color combination I want to have right now. After the uniform, I'm now going to apply a sunny skin tone to all of the skin areas of the models. I changed my brush to a 00 in this case. This is way enough. I mean, I don't want to take for ages, and it's even quite fine also to not do it 100% precise, since my yellow and the skin tone always almost match. Still, the sunny skin tone is still too bright. I think I need a shade for that as well at the end. This next step, I'm going to apply a green grain to the things which I think should look a little bit like metal. So this metal box here, and in this case also the other box to the side. Up next are the boots, and I'm using a chocolate brown here for the leathery part of them, and we'll use a brighter color, maybe olive green, for the cotton part of them. Instead of olive, I'm now opting for a pastel green here. The olive yellow here on the right was too green, and I'm more looking for a brighter tone for the footwear, which is cotton, what I'll show you soon. It's almost like the one which is proposed by Revell, so a little bit brighter olive hell, so olive bright. And it will be tuned down by the shade anyway a little bit to a darker tone in the end. But I'm quite happy with the result in between. Now we made some progress here and have the boots in two colors. We have the skin color and we have the metal tone of the boxes carried on the back. Next steps will be to paint the belt and the rest of the uniform. And then we continue with the rifle and the helmet, before we then will use a shade. Next step is to paint the rifle wood and the water bottle in brown. Since I don't have the flat brown tone, I'm trying out a beige brown here. Now you see the soldier with some black ammunition boxes, and the rifle got some basic black gray. And the next step will be that I'm applying a gunmetal gray to some of the parts of the rifle. If you ask yourself why I'm using first the black gray and then the gunmetal gray, have a look at this gun here. It's not fully covered if you just use the black gray, since the black gray doesn't have as good pigmentation. So I go for first black gray and then gunmetal gray, and I'm fine. And I think the last step before shading, I will try out to put some of the helmets to a green type here. So Afrika Korps tank crew, which should be like the the one proposed here, so the grün-braun. So now some of the helmets are also painted. And I think I'm good now with my details, since I'm painting for tabletop and not for diorama. I will stop here, and the next step will be to apply a shade. I'm going for Argax Erx shade here, and we will see how that turns out. I'm using a special brush I got from Citadel. I once bought a package which is specialized for shade, but I assume you can use any brush which can hold a lot of fluid. Then you just make sure you have a lot of fluid and that you will cover all areas of the model. There can be some where you apply more and there can be areas with less, but apply it to all the areas. Don't be shy, you can take it away where you think it's too much. It will get you some of the details back, especially on the uniform. And it will make sure everything is looking a little bit more used. Since we are at war, it's not like coming out of a shopping mall. You want to have it used. It will automatically go to some of the detail areas. Yeah, put it a little bit better in the light and look if the autofocus gets it. Not very much. I think I will make some photos at the end to show the result. They are still drying up a little bit from the shade, but you get the feeling the details of the jacket are coming back out again and nothing is looking real bright. Quite happy with the result. And the last step, I brought back some details with a bright color. Try to use again some sand yellow here and there, especially at the positions where I think the uniform is worn and therefore a little bit brighter, and the gear. So in the end you will see this things more, and you have to always think it's tabletop, so you need to take a perspective like 1 meter away and see if it's looking good then. I'm fine for now. As you see, I have some more things to do in the background. If you like my video, leave a subscription and thumbs up. See you in the next time.